So there are four main players in the war in Yemen. On the one side, you have the Saudi-led coalition, which includes predominantly the United Arab Emirates, but also other Arab states. And the US and the UK are backing that coalition diplomatically and logistically. That conglomerate is in support of the Houthi government, which is an internationally recognized government in Yemen. On the other side of the conflict, you have the Houthis, which are a rebel group from the north of Yemen. They are actually a family, but their followers are called the Houthis, named after the family. And they're supported by the former president of Yemen, President Ali Abdullah Saleh. And he has a number of loyalists, primarily from the Yemen military, in his cadre, and they're supporting the Houthi effort. The Houthis decided in late 2014 to come from their hometown in the mountains in the north into Sana'a, and they came into the city in September 2014. And they essentially held the Houthi government hostage for a series of months. Eventually, President Houthi resigned in January, and by February, the Houthis had taken the reins of the government. Houthi escaped. He went to Aden, which is a southern city. The Houthis attempted to bomb his presidential palace, and it was at that point in time that the Saudi-led coalition decided to enter the conflict. There's different opinions on how it could have been avoided. Some believe that the root cause is really in 2012, when former President Saleh, after the Arab Spring, was removed from power, and that because he was given an immunity deal and he was allowed to remain in Yemen, he was able to meddle in the background. So he was able to lend his support to the Houthis, who eventually took over Sana'a. So some suggest it could have been avoided if he had not been given an immunity deal or not been allowed to stay in Yemen. Others suggest the root cause is a bit later, that President Houthi, when he was brought in to build a consensus government, they had a national dialogues for a couple of years in Yemen to bring all the parties, all the constituencies in Yemen together to form, you know, consensus. And there were a number of parties, including the Houthis, who felt marginalized in that process. So some suggest had the national dialogues been more inclusive, this wouldn't have happened. Others say it's economic reasons or there's a lack of a unified military. There are a lot of root causes for the current conflict. Well, not really. Although sectarianism is on the rise in Yemen as a result of this war, so it is true that Iran is backing the Houthis and the Saudi and Sunni Arab coalition are backing the Houthi government. So, but in terms of underlying reasons, did the Houthis go to war because the Saudis are Sunni or because Houthi is Sunni? No. Did the Saudis enter the conflict in Yemen for the primary reason that the Houthis are Shia? No, they didn't. There are other underlying reasons which are much stronger. But that said, sectarianism in the country is on the rise, in part because of the perception of it. So Saudi Arabia's objective is really to restore what they consider a legitimate power to power in Sana'a, and also to ensure their own territorial integrity, to ensure that they don't have a rebel group on their border which is sending missiles into their country and potentially, you know, harming their citizens. The Houthi-Saleh bloc are really trying to establish a place for themselves in a future government in some form. It's quite that simple. Well, the West has many reasons to support it. First of all, the Saudi Arabia and many of those in the coalition are the United States' allies and also the UK's allies. Also, the United States perceives this as a rebel group usurping power from a legitimate government. So Hadi was considered an internationally legitimate leader. And so restoring that that legitimacy is important for the US. Now, some suggest it's a quid pro quo for the Iran deal. And while that may be true, there's also other solid reasons for why the West has gotten into this conflict. Yes, Iran does support the Houthis. They publicly have said so. In addition, the United States has argued that Iran is supplying weapons to the Houthis. They claim to have intercepted several shipments. They also have designated several Hezbollah members who are involved in the conflict in Yemen. The reason Iran is supporting the Houthis is a bit more nuanced than just because the Houthis are Shia. Iran has a policy of supporting revolutionary or rebel groups around the region under certain circumstances. For example, they support Hamas, which is not a Shia group. But it should not be confused that Iranian support does not mean the Houthis are a proxy. The Houthis do not take direction from Iran, and it is possible that the Houthis would be willing to give up that relationship under some sort of peace agreement. Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula is the war against that group is oftentimes called the parallel war. So there's this war going on with the Houthis on one side, but then Al-Qaeda still exists in the south, and the coalition is in fact fighting them as well in Yemen. So there's really two wars in Yemen. And even if the war with the Houthis is resolved, Al-Qaeda will remain a threat. Al-Qaeda tends to take advantage of security vacuums in Yemen. They've done it for years. And so as long as there is a security vacuum, they will continue to be active.